Okay, we're here in section 10B, and I want to explain first of all what these first few problems are, this u-substitution. So far, we have learned how to solve quadratic equations. You're pretty good at that. Things like, I don't know, x squared. Oop, I need to choose my correct tool. There we go. X squared plus 3x plus 2 equals 0. You're pretty good at solving stuff like that. So you've got your x squared term, your x to the first term, your constant term, and then equals 0. That's pretty easy to do. Now what we're going to work on is we are going to work on solving equations that are kind of like this. They're of this form, but they're not exactly quadratic equations. But you'll notice something about them. So let me pause to get to the next slide. Okay, here I am on the next slide. And I want you to notice these, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 problems. They are not actually quadratic equations. They don't have the x squared in them. They have something close to the x squared. But I want you to notice something about them, because these are the kinds we're going to, these are the exact kinds of problems we're going to be solving using substitution. Okay, notice something about them. What do you notice first? Probably that they all equal 0. What else do you notice about them all? Hopefully you're noticing that they all have 3 terms. They all have 3 terms. Now I want you to notice one other thing. The third term here on the left side is always just a number, a constant term. Okay, and then the last thing to notice, probably the most difficult thing, but notice the relationship between the first term and the second one. Look at that. Do you notice anything there? And here's what it is. Remember, we're comparing these to regular old quadratic equations that look something like, I don't know, whoopsie, again, my pen tool. Something like 3x squared plus 2x minus 7 equals 0. Something like that. That's what we're comparing it to. Okay, notice right here. I'm not looking at the 3 and the 2. I'm just looking at the variable part right there. That x squared is that thing squared, right? That is that squared. Notice the same thing here. Again, not looking at the 2, not looking at the coefficients. That is that squared. It really is. If you take this and square it, you get that. If you take x plus 3 to the 1/3 and you square it. So I'm going to use a power rule here because it's something to a power to a power. So we multiply our powers. What do I get when I multiply 1/3 times 2? Well, that's like 1/3 times 2 over 1. I get x plus 3 to the 2/3. Whoops, 2/3 and plus 3. There we go. So I get this, in other words. So this right here is indeed this squared. Same relationship as these two. Same thing here. This right here is this squared. This right here is this squared. And this right here is this squared. Notice I'm not looking at like the coefficients, just the variable thing here, right here. So these three equations, we would say they're not quadratic equations. We would say they are in quadratic form. They're in the same kind of format as a quadratic equation. These are the kinds of equations we are going to solve using u-substitution. Let me get to the next slide.